Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to look at setting up some template tabs. These are useful when you've got a large number of templates and you want to organize them and group them together, typically by business function. So it might be your safety form templates, your quality form templates, your commercial templates, and so on and so forth. So we're going to look at how we can set that up on the Dashpivot website. And it's worth just making a note that the template tabs, which will appear along this bar here, can only be set up and changed at a company level within your template library. So that's if you're within a project team, you won't be able to make any changes to the tabs. It's all configured from your template library. And so we're going to create some tabs. You can see that we've got several templates here already, but they haven't been grouped under any tabs because we don't have any. So at the moment, we've just got this all tab. And to create a new tab, we just click this plus button. And let's call one safety. We can add different colors as well. This can help to, I guess, color code all of the tabs. So we've got red for safety, let's make one for commercial, and make it yellow. And then maybe we'll make one for quality. So we'll do it with blue. And so you can create as many tabs as you want. And once you've set them up, you can then go and assign your templates to any of these tabs. So let's select this defects template and this non-conformance template. We want to assign that to the quality tab. So let's, once we make the selection, the option up the top appears, add to tab. Just going to click that button and then choose from the tabs that we've set up. So we'll click quality. And now you can see that we have our two templates sitting under quality. And then everything else that hasn't been allocated to a tab shows up down the bottom here. It says untagged. So we need to allocate these ones to our other tabs that we have set up. So let's select the site diary and the variation and add that to the commercial tab. And last but not least, the incident report and the toolbox meeting. Let's add that to the safety tab. Great, so now you can see that all of our templates have been allocated to the different tabs. This means that if we're viewing our template section in any project team or within our template library, if we click on any of these tabs, it's only going to show us the templates that have been added into those tabs. So it's just a nice way of organizing everything. Of course, you can still see all of the templates in the All tab, but it just makes it a little easier to find what you're looking for when you have 20, 30, 40, 50, 100 templates inside of Dashpivot. Now, you can rearrange these tabs if it's convenient for you. You can change the order. You can change the name by double-clicking. And just typing in whatever you need. You can change the color as well. If you need to delete a tab, you just click the red trash can icon there, and it will delete the tab and remove any of the templates that were added to that tab in the process. And then when you go to create any new templates, you'll now see the option as part of the setup process to allocate the new template that you're creating to any of these tabs. So as an example, if we click add template and we want to build our own, there is an option here now. And let's say we were creating environmental inspection. We could choose any of the tabs that we have set up to allocate it as part of that process. So we don't have to do it later. We just do it as part of the process of setting up a template. And last but not least, removing a template from a tab works the exact same way. So let's say that we wanted to remove this variation template from the commercial tab. We would select it and we would click the remove from tab option. Note that that actually doesn't appear if you select it in the all section because we don't have a particular tab selected. Just keep that in mind. One last thing. You can add templates to more than one tab. So we could choose a template and add this to the quality tab as well. And you'll actually see that even though it's the same template, because it's got the same template ID, you can see that it's listed under both the commercial templates and under quality. And so, yeah, if you're viewing all of your templates in the register view, you can actually see that the site diary has two tabs applied to it. And if we go to commercial, that tab shows the diary. And if we go to quality, that also shows the diary. So it's a nice, neat, sort of handy way of organizing everything. I hope that that has all made sense. If you get stuck with anything, you can always send our team a message via the live chat. We also have some other articles if you're interested in learning about other areas of Dashpivot. And as always, thanks for watching.